First things first, thank you so much for 20K, y'all. The Mafia is 20K strong. We out here. We're getting it.
Gay. I don't know what I'm doing, but gay.
Shit that I've heard black people say, this one has to be in the top five. And I still hear this every day. I just heard somebody say this shit a couple days ago. I was talking to one of my guy friends. We was having this conversation, okay? And I said, you know what? I would actually love to date a white boy one day. Like, I would have absolutely no problem dating a white boy. Probably wouldn't marry him just because I prefer to marry a Haitian man. You know, I want to continue my lineage. Not that I can't with a white man, but I prefer to marry a Haitian man. But I mean, I would have no problem, like, falling in love with a, you know, white man. That would be cool. I would love to date one, you know, just to see what the experience is. And my friend was like,
Oh no. See, now when black men date white women, it's different from when black women date white men. Like, black women shouldn't be dating white men, because you know back in the day they used to use y'all sex dolls.
So black men could date white girls, but black girls can't date white men. Can y'all get the fuck out this slave mentality? Like, could y'all stop this bullshit? Do y'all realize that the only thing stopping you is you? What's wrong with us, bruh? It's 2018. Let me do. I was shocked when I had this shit. I don't understand this whole slave master situation. This doesn't really make sense. Like, okay, why are y'all so damn imprisoned in y'all minds? Okay, white supremacy never stopped you from picking up a damn book. Okay, white supremacy never stopped you from doing anything that you didn't want to do. I feel like a lot of people are mind trapped. You guys learn this stupid shit. You guys pick up this stupid shit from society. You guys pick up this caca from social media and you apply it to your lives and you take that shit as fact. This is a problem. Like, I don't understand why a lot of black people have this logic of putting everything on white people. White people are so damn evil. You need to understand these damn white people that are alive today, not all, but a lot of them don't even understand what the hell y'all talk about. They can't empathize, they can't sympathize, they don't know. They don't understand, they will never understand. And a lot of you black people ain't never been through shit. So I need to understand where this animosity is coming from. At the end of the day, if you love somebody, you should be able to be with them, whether they are your same race or not. It's the same thing with these women. I see a lot of women get so upset when white girls date black men. They're like, oh no, they stealing all our men. We don't even have many, you know, black men left. We don't have any good black men left. Why are they stealing our men? And I'm just like, are you guys serious? Like, are you guys serious? The funny thing is, like, a lot of black men and women aren't even compatible. And I made a whole video about this. A lot of black men and women are not even compatible because of the way we're raised. We're not raised completely to be compatible in the first place. And black women spend all their time bashing black men. And black men spend all their time bashing black women. But for whatever reason, when they go to another race, it's a problem. Like, I don't get it. Are we supposed to just stick to each other and suffer and just talk shit about each other and just reproduce and, you know, produce offspring that's gonna have the same toxic mindset? I would love to know what the logic is here, because this doesn't make sense. I've been hearing this type of shit all my life. Like, I've really heard this all my life, and now that I'm thinking about it, I'm like, this is really dumb. And I have a lot of people in my life who are in interracial relationships, and it's funny, like, they tell me they don't like going certain places because they get discriminated against. One of my friends, she did a capstone on it, and it was so interesting. Like, one of the stories that one of the couples was talking about in her capstone, if you know what, I actually might link it down below. You guys should watch it if it's on YouTube still. I think it is. It was a very good capstone. Like, basically they were talking about how, like, you know, they went to the grocery store. When they go to the grocery store, or people look at them like they're not even together, like they try to check them out separately because they don't think they're together because one's white and one's black. Like, this is ridiculous. We're in 2018. Like, what? This is a serious problem. Everyone should be able to date whoever the hell they want. Okay, whether they just want to be white on white, black on black, black on white. If they want to be a fucking Oreo, let them be a damn Oreo. Like, who cares? I see comments all the time on my channel, on my live streams, on my Instagram.
I need to rant on these interracial couples. Oh, these white women taking on black men. Or, oh, I'm tired of seeing these sisters dating these white men. Like, there's not plenty good black men.
But why you mad though? Maybe they like white girls. Maybe they like black boys. Like, who gives a shit? Like, yo, this shit blows me. Who cares? If they want to date someone of the opposite race or a different race, let them. Like, why does it bother you? I don't understand why people get so upset over things that do not directly affect their everyday life. It is okay to have an opinion, okay? If you sit there and you're like, oh, I do not think that black people should date white people, that's your opinion, okay? But I mean, at least have a valid opinion. Don't just be like,
oh, well, back in the day, they used to rape the black woman, so, you know, they just shouldn't be dating.
This is a whole nother person. Like, you probably don't even know them. Like, people get so upset at these interracial YouTube couples. Personally, I don't like YouTube couples, period. I only follow like maybe 2-3 max. I do not like YouTube couples. I do not subscribe to YouTube couples. I think they're all fake. I think they're boring as shit. And I that's not the type of content that I like, because they do pranks. I don't watch pranks. They do these stupid challenges. I don't watch challenges. That's just my personal preference. But I would never sit there like, oh no, these interracial couples, ugh. They make me sick. Like, damn, bitch. We back to Jim Crow, bitch. Like, damn. Like, is it that serious? Like, what happened to all the love and the peace and the tranquility and equality, all of that? Like, what happened? Pa ko puan, ma bise ko puan. I don't see the problem. I feel like people should just be able to date who the fuck they want. It just shouldn't be that much of an issue. If I want to date a white man, I can date a white man. If I want to date a green man, I can date a green man. Like, who gives a shit? Like, I just find it funny because a lot of people see it one way. A lot of people are always like, oh, black women shouldn't be dating white men specifically. And it's just like, every time I hear a black person or a white person or anybody say some stupid shit like this, I just wanna throw my head in the toilet. I don't know, that just came off the top of my head. I just wanna throw my head in the toilet. Cause how can you be so stupid? From what I see in history, you know, from the rappers to the actors and just in everyday life, I see a lot of black men. They come up. I see a lot of people, they out here, they do what they gotta do in life, they're making it in the world, and you know, by their side it's a black woman. But then all of a sudden, as soon as they actually make it and they're at a pinnacle, somehow they end up marrying a white woman and now they have biracial kids. You don't see me out here like, oh, black men shouldn't be dating white women because they only use us as pawns, and then they go to white women, which is the pattern that I've seen. I don't sit there and say that nonsense. Don't name no names. There's a couple celebrities out there who's done that. Hey, they was with black women on the come up, and then when they actually made it, they switched to white women. I mean, it's just a common pattern that I see. I'm not about to sit there and be like, oh, black men shouldn't be dating white women. That's your business. Do what you want. But my problem is, black people, okay, black men in particular, will sit there and they will use black women, okay? I've seen it. I've been used, okay? They'll use you on their come up. Okay, and that's what happens. A lot of women, it's not even the fact that, oh, you know, he's white, I'm gonna go to the white man, you know. It's not that type of situation. A lot of the times they just go where they are appreciated. And a lot of black women do not feel appreciated by their black men. That's the issue here. It's not an issue of, oh, well, I want light-skinned babies, which some people, they do. Some people actually do, you know, I want light-skinned babies with pretty hair, so I'm gonna marry a white man or a Spanish man. People do that. That's not what I'm talking about here. I'm talking about people who actually have common sense to not be as frivolous to care that much about what their kids come out like. I'm talking real shit here, right? Black people will date white people, or white people will date black people, whatever the case may be, because they do not feel appreciated by their race. It's the same thing. I've heard white girls tell me that they like dating black men because the black men appreciate them more. I've heard black men say they like dating white women because, you know, black women are too aggressive and they're more appreciated and then they listen to them more. And we all know, yeah, black women can be very aggressive. Like, I'm aggressive as hell, I ain't gonna lie. But I know how to submit in a relationship. But a lot of black girls don't, because a lot of them, they're very independent. They've grown up to be, you know, independent. They've grown up to not take shit from anyone. A lot of them, literally, all my life I had to fight. Like, a lot of them are like that. So it's like, I understand. That's why I would never sit there and try to tell somebody that it doesn't make sense for them to date the opposite race. Whatever it is that welcomes you is whatever welcomes you. I've heard a lot of white men say that white women don't like them because, you know, they're too submissive or they're too nice, you know? And, you know, they want black women because black women are, they tend to be more aggressive. They tend to say what they want. I've heard it all, trust me. I've heard a lot of things as far as people going to another race when it comes to dating or marriage or whatever the case may be. A lot of it is not as clear cut as, oh, well, back in the day they used to rape y'all, so y'all shouldn't be with them. Like, that just doesn't really make much sense. If you have that type of opinion, please make sure you take that opinion and shove it up your ass. Like, if you simply do not like interracial relationships, that's you. But at least have a real reason and don't say stupid shit like that. Like, that just doesn't really make much sense. It just makes you sound racist. And then don't be one of those dumbass people that said,
oh, black people can't be racist.
I don't care. Black people can be racist. Okay, look up the definition of racist and then tell me if you can or cannot be racist. I'm tired of black people saying that stupid shit. Okay, at the end of the day, racist is racist. It doesn't matter. Stop trying to change definitions to fit your needs, your desires, and your tribulations. Racist is racist. I don't want to see no dumbass paragraphs under my video like, oh,
well, black people can't be racist because, you know, they're the minority or blah, blah, blah. They've been oppressed. So, blah.
Shut up. Anyone can be racist, okay? I don't want to hear nobody's racist views. Like, it's so funny how a lot of y'all sing different tunes when it's convenient for y'all. If you're gonna be racist under my video, you're going to get blocked, deleted, or hidden from my channel. I don't have time for that. I don't have time for ignorant people. I don't have time for ignorant comments. Like, at the end of the day, it's not about being woke. It's not about being conscious. It's all about being sensible at this point, because this shit just doesn't make sense. There's a lot of things that people say, a lot of things that people do that just make no damn sense, and I just be confused. Confused, confused, confused. And for you people who sit there and comment on my video talking about, oh, I need to drag white people, you guys are ridiculous as hell. Okay, ridiculous as hell. But I will not be dragging white people. I will not be dragging anyone who doesn't need to be dragged. Okay, I'm not about to sit there and just pick and nit shit from white people. I'm not white. I was never in the white community, so I cannot relate to them. I'm black, so I can talk about black people. I'm black, like, I'm Haitian. I can talk about that stuff, right? Listen, take that racist shit to somebody else's channel. We're not doing that here, okay? All right, thank you. Listen, y'all, if you are in a interracial relationship and people are giving you shit, tell them to fuck off. Tell them mind their business. Tell them that you don't give a fuck, okay? Tell them that they need to get right with their mind, right with whatever God they believe in, because listen, there's no use arguing with these people. There's no use getting upset. Literally, live your life with your little beautiful light skin mixed babies, okay? Keep stirring the pot. Keep melting the pot. Do what you gotta do. Do you. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section below. Do you have a problem with interracial relationships? Are you in an interracial relationship? Like, do you love interracial relationships? Let me know what y'all think about interracial relationships down in the comment section below. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow me on social media, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.